Hi there, so today we are going to create some word art using EIL library Python. So you can see here the code it is written with now, that is code it now the channel name. So the code it is written with now inside it. So we are going to learn how to do this with Python. So basically, first of all, you need to make image with now, that is first string, the string which you're gonna print inside. You need to fill the first entire image with that thing. So for initial stage, so the first line would be now till the width. Then create image with entirely filled with that string, and then create the actual image with actual outer string, and then replace all the white spaces, white part, that is 255, 255, 255 with the value at the same pixel in this image. This will give you the output, the actual output that we wanted. So let's just see it in a programming way. That was the conceptual way, that is first create image with one line, then create image entirely filled with the first inner string, then create image with the outer string, and then merge these two image. That's what we have done in the previous video, like we were creating image and font with the gradient, then first we were creating gradient and then we were filling the gradient into the font side. So let's start with the coding. So basically, here are the header files. Now we are creating image, black image with 900:900 resolution. Then S would be our first string, multiply that string by 25 or any number that would give you the entire width size of the image of this string. That is, I'm multiplying it by 25, so it would give me now 25 times. That is, the ST would be now 25 times. Okay, then create some font and then draw that font onto the image. Here you can see that all the colors are random. So to get that random things, I have used RGB random values over here, so that all the colors of the line would get some different colors, so that it look quite nice. So basically what we have done is, in this section we have created this first image with one line, one entire line of our inner string. So let's just see how it works. Okay, so we have got the image with one inner line at the top. Now once you have image at the top, once you have image with the inner line at the top, in second thing, in the parameter for the location for the first line would be 0, 0, the leftmost corner, left upper corner, but for the second string it would be 0. First parameter would be 0, but the second parameter would be height of the first line. For the third line it would be 0, height of the previous two line. For the fourth line it will be 0, height of the first three lines. So to get this thing, let's just store first height of the first line in one variable, that is height equals to h, and then every time we would store that height equal to height plus h, that is the height of one line would be h and the height of all previous line would be stored in height. So the height should not exceed 900, so we are getting a loop of while height would be lesser than 900, that is because the 900 is height of an image. So similarly here, random things for random RGB and color value, and then draw dot text 0, height. Do not think about this line and this thing at this time. I would explain this later part of the video. So ST font equals to font and font fill RGB. I have already explained this, how to use and put some text on image in my previous video, how to give gradient and all. So please refer those video if you are not getting this thing. So just run it. First image with one line and second image entirely filled with the inner string. So we have done with this part. So now create image with code it. You can easily create this image with code it. You can refer my previous video if you don't know how to get this image. Let's run this code. First line, second line. It will take some time because the loops are multiple times, and you can see that the image has been created. So basically what we have done is we have created the one image, new image one variable with new 900x900 resolution, and here we have used fnt.ttf. I already saved this font at my Python project library, Python project directory. You can download any font, but just make sure the fonts are wider enough to see the inner string. So just take some bold font so you can see inner string clearly, then code it string, and then I'm centering it. You can refer my videos how to center your string into the to print in an image. So now let's see how actual part works. So we would compare every pixel and put every pixel from the first image. So from 900x900 loop, that is from I from 0 to 900 and J from 0 to 900. So we are getting value of every pixel. Okay. So every time the loop will run, you will get every pixel value, and then you will compare it. If the pixel value is 255, 255, 255, 255, that is if the pixel value is white, then we are replacing that pixel value with the pixel value from this image. So at this part, put pixel I comma j, img.getPixel means if I, and suppose this place is I can say 200x400j, that is 200i and 400j. If this pixel is 200, 400, then it will, sorry, so at this space this line would be executed, and to add 200x400 from value from this image would be replaced over here. Then okay, I think so every time the loop will execute it, it will check every single pixel and it will replace it with the first image value. So let's just run this code. First image, definitely it will take some time because the loops are two more. The third image and fourth image would take quite longer because it would run 900x900 loop. So you can see the output, it's enough clear. And now the one thing is unexplained, and that is what is all these things. You can see that when you zoom it, the n here, these things are not inclined, and it looks good when things are not inclined in this way. You can clearly see these things in the second image. That is, n is not the start of every string, every line, and it looks nice because if now every line, your every line would start with now, it would look quite similar in the final image too. So it should be random. To get this thing randomly, I have used this thing. So what I have done is, I have get the random value from 0 to length of the string, and then I have added that thing before the string, so that your string that 25 times now would be that 25 times now would have something before that 25 times hello, 25 times now, and that can be n, or that can be on, or that can be non completely. So this thing would add no or no or now.